Okay, this is Diablo Take Television, and we are delighted to have a special young lady on the line that we'd like to talk to and let you hear it from her. But this is Tempe Williams of Diablo Take Television, and on the line we've got Mary Sylvester talking to us now from Germany. Mary, are you here?
Yes, I'm there. How are you, Tempe? How are you, Albert?
We're fine, Mary.
Happy New Year to you both. We're fine. And Mary, right now, we really appreciate you calling. And what I'd like you to do is just talk to us. Just tell us what you want us to know.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about Mary Sylvester.
Yeah, I just like the way you said what we would like to know, because it's very good, because I think I'm a little bit private person, so I will tell you exactly what you want to know. So, so we can laugh, we can have a good laugh on that one, okay.
Yeah, we
so
can.
What you know about me is what it is. I'm a musician, and I live in Germany in a town called Freiburg, a little bit on the outside in the Black Forest. And I do music here. I'm more into blues and jazz and gospel. And before I had many bands, and I did reggae and other things, but now I'm more like into another, you know, more like gospel and other things, too,
yeah.
Music. And so that's what I'm doing right now. I travel once a year to Dominica because I've formed an organization here.
Okay.
Called the Dominica Charity Foundation, and we try to support the Marigot Hospital. That is a town in Dominica where I was born, and my family lived, and our whole family is all over the world right now, but eventually when we end up in Dominica, we end up there.
Yeah.
So we thought also the fact that the airport, the main airport in Dominica, is called the Melvin Hall Airport for the people who don't know. And this airport is situated like 5 or 10 minutes ride, I think, driving from the Marigot village. And that's where the main hospital is. So I always think it's a good idea in case anything would happen, not wishing anything bad to happen, but in case that this hospital should be so filled with things that we, you know, could help out before the real help comes.
Yes.
And so we send every year wheelchairs, walkers, crutches, and medication. I try to bring some things for the kids and toys and stuff. And so that's what I'm doing right now. And it's nice to do that, to see the joys on the faces and to see that people, you know, walk. One of the greatest, let me see what I would say when I'm there, what makes me real happy. Sometimes I speak German every day, so it's really, really difficult for me to get my English words together.
That's okay.
So what makes me very happy is, like, after we bring the things to Dominica, it's
yes.
a lot of trouble bringing these things there, and it's a lot of trouble getting the things out of the custom. But the greatest joy is to see an older man walking with two sticks. And these sticks have in Germany, the sticks have a light on them, so in the dark it shines. And so if you're there and it's dark and you see them walking with the sticks, then you know, oh, I've made this possible,
yes.
that they are walking. That is the things that sometimes God shows you in your life, the way that this is a good thing, and it brings so much joy. There are so many things that could make you not want to do this work, because there's lots of disappointment and
yes.
people that don't care. But naturally, one little good thing makes you want
makes
to
it all worthwhile.
Make it more worthwhile, and so we try to do it every year. And I think the hospital, we got a letter this year saying thank you after many years. I thought maybe in the beginning they took a lot of things for granted, not seeing the hard work and dedication behind the whole thing. But I think now they have really realized that it takes a lot of work to do something like this, and a lot of money to send the things there. And I think I saw this year some appreciation, which I was very happy about. So that's one part of my life, what I could tell you about. Another part what I can tell you about is like my father's place in Dominica. That is a guest house what we built up with my family.
Yes.
And this place belongs to me and my brothers,
mm-hmm.
I would say. And you all are welcome to go there and stay there. My father's place is the beach, one of the white sand beaches behind the house called Sun Bay. It's
okay.
The only beach in this area, I think, that so it's an easy place to find. The thing about running my father's place as a guest house, it never worked out since we had it in, I think it's going now on the 6th year or 7th year, and it never really worked out because we were never able to find the right management.
Okay.
And in Dominica, there's no, at least where we looked, there was no form of management. Everything was just taken for a joke, like we were abroad and they get paid every month, so we would send the money to pay them. When you call there, nobody was there, nobody to pick up the phone. Some people were there, you know, nobody to open the gates, or, you know, just really, really bad. So, totally disappointed about that because I thought, if someone, you know, give anybody a place like we gave most of them in our village area,
mm-hmm.
to be in control and to say, whatever you do, I share it with you. Somebody had done this for me in my life,
yes.
I think I would be the richest person.
Yes.
So they just took everything for a joke, and, oh, she pays every month, and, you know, that was sort of like the important thing. So the place is a little bit run down right now, but I think, you know, eventually it will come back up because I'm looking for the right person, but internationally, like on sort of like giga jobs or something like that, to find somebody that really knows about hotel management business and stuff like that, and maybe we will have some, you know, better outcome in the future for my father's place.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Mary, listening to you, we applaud you because, you know, we know it's not easy, but in every family, I think in every situation, there always has to be that one person, and you're that person, it seems like. So, where I'm sure it gets frustrating for you, just know that your efforts, I totally appreciate it. And let me ask a question. What is it that we can do? Because we want to play this on Diablote television, and our platform will be playing on Web TV 24/7. So who knows? People will be able to hear. And so what is it that, if someone hears you right now, what can they do to help you at this moment? What can they do to help lift some of the burdens off of you right now in terms of your hospital efforts, in terms of the management that you're looking for? What is it that they can do, and who can they contact so that it'll get to you for some ready help?
Yeah, okay. So that's a good question, and I think I don't like, you know, like just to take handouts or things like that. So I look at it like I've made like 10 CDs in my life.
Okay.
And most of these CDs, I think, are on Amazon.com. And you can download these CDs, you know, one song that you like.
Okay.
So let's say 1,000 people would download one song for 1 euro or whatever, euro or whatever, how they call it, I don't know. We call it euros over here.
Okay.
And or $1 or 60 cents, or we get some downloads, then I'm willing to donate the first 1,000 to the organization so that we can help to send the boxes away.
Okay.
You know, so that's like one thing that would be good.
Okay.
Another thing, like the people could get together and make one click on the website and say it says www.dominica-charity.org, and that's the name of the website, and you can see all what we are doing there. That definitely there are pictures showing that the things are being delivered, picked up from Roseau in a truck, being, you know, brought to Marigot, being delivered to the hospital. The hospital bus comes and takes the things, and, you know, all these things are displayed on the website so that the people can see this is a real thing.